reusable test bench. Look at this example, treadmill. You go to any fitness club, you find treadmills. There may be hundreds of customers, I would say even thousands, but they are not going to keep hundreds of machines. They are going to keep maximum 5 to 10 machines. So here the important thing is, everyone will make use of the same machine. Let's say three different people, they are going to use this treadmill one by one. So here the important thing is, each individual, they have their own objective. Look at this. This person, he wants to run at 8 km/h and he wants to burn 200 calories in 30 minutes. And he doesn't want to change the slope. So basically his focus is bodybuilding. So here he has his own objective. Now look at the other scenario. She is very new to fitness club. She hasn't used this treadmill, so she doesn't want to run. She wants to walk. She wants to walk slowly at 6 km/h or maybe 5 km/h. She wants to feel how this machine works. And once she becomes comfortable, maybe after a week, she would like to run. So here, her objective is entirely different. Now, look at this scenario. He has been running regularly, so straight away he wants to run at 12 km/h and he wants to build stamina. His objective is participating in marathons, so while running he wants to change the slope. So basically he wants to feel like how he can run on ups and downs, various slopes. So here three different people, they have different objectives, but everyone is going to use the same machine. Look at this. So how they make use of this machine? They get on the machine, they press reset, all the settings will go off, and they make their setting. There is a control panel. Look at here. They make all the settings. How fast they want to run, how much time they want to run, how many calories they want to burn, how they want to change the slope. They are going to make all the settings and then they are going to run. Once they complete, they will stop the machine, they will walk away. The next person goes, the person presses the reset button, all the settings will go off and this person will make the new settings. How much time she wants to run, how she wants to run, whether she wants to have slope, how many calories she wants to burn. And then she will put up the machine, she will walk away. The next person goes. This is how everyone will make use of the same machine. This is the perfect example for reusability. And this is how basically we want to build the test bench. So we want to create configurable test bench. Something similar to this treadmill. The test case writer should be able to configure the test bench with various parameters. Let's look at how it works. Here you look at this. Two things are there. One is verification environment. It's like treadmill, it's like machine. It's going to do certain things repeatedly. Look at this, it's going to do certain things repeatedly. On top of this verification environment, different test case writers, they will be writing different test cases. So they are going to configure the test bench with various parameters. And they are going to generate different kinds of stimulus. Look at this. This is design. What this verification environment does, it does certain things repeatedly. It generates packet, it drives packet to the design. When it produces the output, it collects the output packet and compares the output packet with the expected packet. That's what it's going to do repeatedly. Let's say the design is a router. Then the test case writer might say, all right, I'm going to generate 100 small packets. So in this case, it's going to generate 100 small packets. So the test bench is going to generate 100 small packets, and it's going to collect all the outputs. It's going to compare the output packets with expected packets. In this case, router, so obviously input packets. Test case one. Test case two, different test case writer. He might say like, I'm going to generate 10 big packets, entirely different, 10 big packets. So based on the input, it's going to generate 10 big packets. It's going to drive all the big packets. When the design produces output, it's going to collect all the output and compare the output packets with input packets. Test case two over. Now test case three. This test case writer might say, I'm going to generate bad packet. So I'm going to generate one bad packet. I'll generate the packet, and what I'm going to do, I'm going to corrupt the parity. So in this case, I want to see how the design is going to reject the packet. So based on the input, the verification environment is going to generate bad packet. It will generate good packet first, and then it will correct the parity. Then it will drive the bad packet to the design. And it's going to check whether it's going to produce the output or it's going to reject the packet. Accordingly, it's going to verify. So here, three test cases. Test case one, 100 small packets. Test case two, 10 big packets. Test case three, one bad packet. This is how basically we generate different kinds of stimulus for the design. This is really needed for the design. So basically we have to take the design through various possible scenarios. And sometimes we have to expose the design to unexpected scenarios. This is how we try to find bugs in the chip. Look at here. Based on the test case definition, the packet will be generated, the packet will be driven, the output packet will be collected, and the output packet will be compared with input packet if it is a networking device. And finally, the test bench is going to produce the report. What kind of packets, how many packets have been generated, and how the packets have been verified, how many test cases passed, how many test cases failed, all kinds of reports will be generated. And that's how basically we automate the simulation. And that's how we verify the chip.